Hi, I'm Gillian Jacobs, and this is the story of my worst date ever. This is a painful one. I think he read an article that was like, fun date in New York, because everything was very pre-planned. So first started with sushi on St. Mark's Place, which is like known for the punk scene, not really its cuisine. Already a little off, but okay, it was fine. And then he had a car, which was like very unusual for like a 23-year-old guy in New York to have a car. But he was like, now we're gonna drive to the Upper East Side, and I'm in the car with him and there's traffic and we're going up the highway and I'm thinking like, where are we going? And then I was like, what's the cheesiest place you could possibly go for dessert? And I was like, oh my God, we're going to Serendipity, which I had taken a lot of like cynical New Yorker pride in never having gone to Serendipity before and didn't have any intention of ever going. So I said, are we going to Serendipity? He's like, maybe. So when we get to the Upper East Side, he can't figure out where to park. He almost drives onto a bridge and has to do like a very illegal U-turn to get off it. We park finally blocks away. We are walking past Scores, the strip club on the Upper East Side. He says, I could get you a job there. Great line to your date. Then we get to Serendipity. There was about like an hour wait because everybody and their mother and every, you know, tourist group goes there. So then he says, let's go to Roosevelt Island. Okay, so for those of you that have never been to the greater New York area, Roosevelt Island used to be a place where they sent people with infectious diseases. It was like where they would quarantine you if you were gonna, you were dying of rubella. And now it's home to some rather severe apartment buildings, and it's kind of depressing. I actually shot some TV shows at some very depressing hospitals there, and I was like, I really don't want to go to Roosevelt Island. It's like 8 p.m. in February, it's freezing cold, it's dark, it's gonna be terrible. But there's like a tram that goes there, so it's like probably on his article list of things to do in New York. So we're taking this tram, and the whole time he's like, isn't this great? Isn't this great? This is, and I'm like, yeah, it's fine, whatever. We get there, it's like whipping wind because it's an island in the middle of the river. It's freezing cold outside, it's pitch dark, there's nothing there. And he's like, let's walk around the garden. I said, like, that frozen piece of dirt over there, there is no garden. Can we please go back? So then we like immediately get back on the tram, go back. We're at Serendipity. There are some girls who are there having their big night in the city. They're sitting next to us. At one point they lean over and they're like, could you please take a picture? And he goes, of me? And they're like, no, of us? Like, we're at Serendipity. I was like, this got to end. Then he insisted on driving me home, even though I really just wanted to take the subway and get away from him. He then was complaining that he could not find how to get to my apartment. Then said, why don't you just come back to my place and my mom will cook you breakfast in the morning? To which I said, no thank you. I told you it was a long one. Finally got back to my place and he like pretended that he couldn't figure out how to get from my apartment to his apartment. Oh my God, this is so embarrassing. Came up to my apartment. Okay, I was so broke, I didn't own a chest of dresser drawers. I had like a bookshelf that somebody had left in the apartment and I put all my clothes on this. So he walks into my room. I was like, here's my laptop, just look it up and then you have to go. And he like walks over to the bookshelf and like picks up a pair of my underwear and is like, ooh. I was like, put that down, put it down. And then he like sits on my little bed. I slept on a chair that folded out into a bed at this point. So he sits down on my little bed, is like patting the like 1 inch of mattress to the side of him, and I was like, get out now! And finally somehow I got him out of my apartment, and for weeks afterwards he texted me pretty consistently and was convinced that like we had this deep connection and that we were gonna start dating, and he was my boyfriend. That was my worst date ever.